Welcome back to Supi Politics. Still with us here in the studio, House Justice Committee Chair, Representative Neil Tupas Jr., House Justice Committee Vice Chair, Representative Rudy Fariñas, Iloilo Representative Augusto Syjuco, and Bayan Muna Representative Neri Colmenares. Join us on the phone in a little while is Congressman Mark Cagas. But before I go to Mark, I wanted to ask Congressman Syjuco something, sir, because you know you said something very interesting kanina, and we're still wala pa po tayo dun sa delikadesa, no? So dun muna tayo sa nung binanggit niyo po yung con-con. Yes. Because one of the things that people will remember forever about that constitutional convention is the allegation that Marcos paid off some delegates to that con-con.
Well, it depends on what you mean by paid off. There were several of us who did not want to sign the constitution because our pet proposals were not there. Mm-hmm. So Marcos called us, about 18 of us. He started at 4 o'clock in the afternoon and we finished at 4 o'clock in the morning. Mm-hmm. And he took each proposal and he talked to the author about it. He was able to convince everyone to sign the constitution who would otherwise would not have signed. Mm-hmm. Okay. And then when it came to me, I showed him the article that I had written, and he read it, and I told him, Mr. President, this will make the Constitution attractive. Mm-hmm. In other words, what I was telling him was that it would be a selling point to a Constitution which had an unpopular transitory provisions. Mm-hmm. So he looked up and he thought about it, and he told the delegate Bibit Duabit at that time, who organized us to talk to him, and he said, Bibit, include it. I only ask you one thing, Boboy. Instead of accountability of public servants, he says, please make it accountability of public officers. Mm-hmm. And I said, no, Mr. President. Yeah. So, in that case, I was not paid off. Mm-hmm. But because he took my proposal, I signed the constitution.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So, hindi po kayo tumanggap ng pera?
Hindi po tayo tumanggap ng pera.
You can say that with a straight
face. I can say that with a straight face, with clean conscience.
Yeah. We'll get back to the delicadeza issue, what you brought up earlier in the hearing. But anyway, let's talk first to Congressman Mark Cagas. Congressman Cagas, good evening.
Yes, ma'am. May gabi. Good evening.
Mm-mm. Sinabi ko na kanina ha, na nag-date ka, kaya wala ka rito ngayon.
Ano?
Truth-telling tayo ngayon, Mark.
Ano, no?
Truth-telling tayo ngayon.
Yes, go ahead, please.
Oo. Sige, Mark, I wanted to ask you, well, basically, just about what you said, that you were quoting Jesus Christ, no? Sabi
yes,
nyo,
that's right.
Those who have not sinned can cast the first
stone. Cast the first stone.
Why did you say that?
You know, Pia, the impeachment process in this country is being treated as not as a judicial process, but mainly as a political process. You know, all of us here are politicians, and we must admit that what happened today and during the previous weeks was a political process. And for me, it did not involve the innocence or the guilt of any respondent whatsoever. But it was a political decision. And only history can judge, let's say, like 20 years from now, ang history lang magjudge sa atin whether, you know, we did the correct or the wrong thing.
What does that have to do with casting the first stone? What are you trying to... May pinaparinggan ba kayo porket may mga congressmen na may kaso sa ombudsman, etc.?
Hindi naman ho kasi because we already prejudge the guilt of the respondent in this case. So, dapat sana nagkaroon ng mas objective na impeachment process. At saka mas hindi sana ganoon ang nangyari. But you know, in any case, it happened already. And it's up to the lawyers of the ombudsman to make the appropriate action.
How can you have an objective impeachment process if it is a political process?
Yes, that's the problem, Pia. I think tama yung sinabi ni Manong Rudy kanina na we have to review the rules governing the impeachment proceedings kasi to make it more impartial rather than partial. Because in any impeachment matter, well, for example, in the last impeachment case filed against the ombudsman, the same people who voted against that impeachment now were the same people who voted for the impeachment. And practically yung mga complaints nung nakaraang impeachment ay pareho lang sa impeachment complaints na final ngayon.
But obviously this is a numbers game, Martin, di ba? And so it was also in the last Congress. It so happens nagbago yung ruling party.
Yes, that's true. That's why, and you know, but I've been consistent with my stance, and as I've said to you during your show last week, you know, we always fight for things and principles and causes that we believe that is correct, and historically, ganun ang ginagawa ng pamilya namin, and in this case, we felt that we believed that the ombudsman was denied her due process, and so we fought for her, and unfortunately, this is a numbers game, and we lost, it's now up to the lawyers again, ombudsman, to file the appropriate action.
Mark, if you believe in that the ombudsman should have gotten due process, then why didn't you wait and stay around to vote?
Excuse me, I'm sorry, Pia.
Why didn't you wait to stay around and vote? Why did you not vote with the nine and six others?
Yes, because I couldn't stomach anymore. Kasi medyo, you know, I'm passionate and I'm emotional, and I couldn't stomach, you know, what was happening, and I've been observing the impeachment process throughout the entire proceedings, and I felt that the rights of the ombudsman here was gravely abused. So hindi ko na kayang masikura, that's why I just went out, and since the complainants are also, you know, mga kasamaan din natin, I didn't want to have any ill feelings towards them. That's why I decided to just... After I said my piece, and then I decided to just go to the office.
Ayaw mo na silang makaaway?
Hindi naman tayo nang-aaway. We fight for the principles, Pia. But not we don't fight personalities, but we fight for principles.
Oh. But I'm sure you'll be in the following proceeding, plenary, for example, no? I mean, you're not going to just abandon...
absolutely not. We will continue to, as I... You know, as I said, I believe that what I'm doing is correct, then we will continue, and I will not wane whether there is no consideration, walang consideration to be, you know, I'm not thinking of anything but, you know, fighting for what I believe is correct.
Okay, so at least we can rest assured that you will be around to make things more interesting.
Yes, in fact,
with your...
In fact, may ang susunod na laban, yung bill namin ni Risa, yung carp law, hindi pumasa yung last Congress eh. I was disappointed.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I'm talking about the impeachment. You know, oh, ibang episode yan yung carp. Teka muna. I'm talking about the impeachment.
It's a metaphor.
Uh-oh. But anyway, well, sige, one last question na lang, Mark.
Yes,
I'm just
yes,
wondering, next time around, who are you going to be quoting naman?
Maybe, I'll probably maybe, be quoting you.
I don't think so.
Maybe put,
maybe
put the biblical quotation in context.
Uh-huh.
This was said by Jesus Christ because the people were stoning Mary Magdalene.
Mm-hmm.
They were lynching her.
Uh-huh,
so
okay.
Jesus Christ said, kung sino walang kasalan, let him cast the first stone.
Uh-huh. Dito Mark, naman, did you have that in mind?
We're not lynching a sinner here without due process. Ito, we were hearing the case.
You were lynching her with due process?
No, we were not lynching. We had due process.
O, teka muna, Mark. So parang, for you, Mary Magdalene, si Mercy Gutierrez? Ano bang... I'm just saying. Ikaw ang gumamit ng Jesus Christ ko.
Si Manong Rudy dapat sumagot siya. After all, siya my classic. And then, I'm